Welcome to this brief guide on how to use Android's Nearby Share with Windows. Most of us are aware of the Apple feature known as AirDrop that allows you to wirelessly share files between devices. But not many people are aware that Android has had a similar feature for some time now called Nearby Share. And with a very recent update, you can now do Nearby Share between your Android device and your Windows PC. In order to get started, we simply head to this website, which I will include a link to in the description of this video. And from here, we're going to want to download and install the Nearby Share for Windows program. Please note that it supports Windows 10 or higher, but is currently not supported on ARM-based devices. In order to begin the process, we simply select the Get Started button, which will download the installation file to our PC. Simply run this file to install the program. Now that I've got the program already installed on my PC, I'm simply going to open it up and you'll see that it prompts me to sign in with my Google account. You can use this without a Google account, but I highly recommend signing in as it does enable some additional features later on. Once I select sign in, it'll open up my browser and ask me to select my appropriate Google account. Once I've selected my Google account, I then select sign in, and then that process is done. I can simply close down that window and head back to the program. From here, I then get prompted to select and customize my settings, such as naming my device. I can also see that I'll be able to share with anybody who has chosen to be visible, and then I can dictate who I can receive files from. One of the things you'll notice here is that it says you will not need to approve sharing from devices that are signed into your Google account. This is that additional feature of being signed in with your Google account. Once done, you can simply select the Done button here, but please note that if you want to change any of these settings afterwards, you can do so quite easily, such as dictating who you can receive files from, including the ability down the bottom here to make your device hidden so that it cannot be accessed via Nearby Share. You can also head over to the settings cog over here on the right hand side, and this will take you to the settings where you can elect to rename your device as well as dictate where the received files you get will be saved to. In my case, I'm saving them to my downloads folder. And now let's try it out. Here you can see I happen to have a screen recording from my own mobile phone, and in my internal storage I have a video file that I'd like to share. So I select the ellipsis menu and select the option from the menu that says share. In the share sheet that appears, I need to select the option that says Nearby Share. This will begin the process of finding any devices around that have Nearby Share enabled. As you can see, it's found my PC and I've elected to connect. Using Bluetooth, it will ping my device, and because I'm signed in with the same Google account on both devices, it's automatically allowing the transfer to be initiated. Now I'll speed the next part of this video up as I am transferring a relatively large file. Now it's worth noting that the technology that's being used to transfer this file is a technology known as Wi-Fi Direct. So whilst Bluetooth is used to initiate the initial connection, Wi-Fi Direct is used to send the file as that is a much more reliable and faster way of doing so. Please note that the speed at which your file is transferred will vary depending on the hardware in both your computer and in your phone, but as you upgrade those devices down the line, your files will transfer faster in future. And here you can see my file has been transferred and it's saved to my downloads folder. And then I have options on the side here where I can either dismiss this notification, or if I wish to, I can simply select the open button, which will open the file on my PC. And as you can see, here's that video file. It's a short highlight reel from my Halo Infinite gameplay the other night. And as you can see, I've got this 85 plus megabyte file that I've been able to send directly from my phone to my PC to view on my much larger screen. But I can also send files from my PC directly to my phone using this app as well. I simply drag and drop the file from File Explorer into the Nearby Share app, at which point it will search for any devices that have Nearby Sharing enabled. Selecting my phone will begin to pair to my phone using Bluetooth just like it did before, and because I have the same Google account signed in on both devices, the file transfer will be automatically accepted on my phone. Now just like I did before, I'm going to speed this process up as it is an extremely large file. This is a PowerPoint file that's over 60 megabytes. This is not something that I would normally be able to send very easily using something like email. But with the power of Wi-Fi Direct and Nearby Share, I've been able to easily send this file from my PC directly to my mobile phone's downloads folder. And from here, I can then simply select the open button to open it up in my app of choice. Now as you can see, I've used a PowerPoint file for this demonstration, but this could be any form of file ranging from documents through to music, through to photos and even videos and more. And I've been able to send them all safely and securely using nearby share between my Android phone and my Windows PC. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and helps make transferring files between your phone and your PC just that much easier in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.